Good morning, everyone. Stephen Whiteside here with our look at the Canadian stock market for Thursday, January 22nd, 2015. It's a little after 8 a.m. on the East Coast, and stock index futures are higher. Dow futures currently up about 100 points. We've got crude oil up in the pre-market. Gold is pulling back a little, down $6. We still are waiting for the news conference out of Europe. So they've put out a statement. Interest rates are staying the same in Europe, but we're still waiting to hear about what stimulus that they're going to apply. And that should happen in the next half hour. Now, the reaction to that news conference, of course, should add to the volatility in the pre-market. Well, we had some volatility yesterday in the Canadian stock market with a surprise announcement from the Bank of Canada. That sent the Canadian dollar heading sharply lower yesterday. Moving in the opposite direction, the Canadian stock market had a good day on Wednesday. It's back on a buy signal. Didn't take out mathematical resistance at 14,687.50. Didn't take out the recent highs, and so we have a nice little trend line across the last two highs. And of course, we're still in the middle of the flypaper channel. And we ran into not only a downtrend line, but the moving average convergence of the 100 and the 200-day moving average there, traded above the 50-day. So didn't gain any new ground yesterday. Anything that was interest rate related went higher, whether it was bonds, whether it was the income trusts, the REITs, real estate stocks, they all continued to move higher. Had a little selling in utilities yesterday, but still trading above the upper channel line. Energy stocks still on a buy signal. That would change on Thursday with a close below 203.87 on the index. A nice move up in the bank stocks yesterday, trading into the channel. Still need some more movement to the upside. A close above 240.54 would give us a buy signal for the financial services index. Gold stocks were up on Wednesday, continuing to move higher. We're trading above the 187.50 level, but we have not had a clean break above it. So we're still attached to that area of resistance. And a clean break above it, of course, is an open, high, low, close, all trading above 187.50. That hasn't happened yet. If that can happen, of course, we're looking for a move up to 200 as our next target. There's healthcare stocks. We're up nicely on Wednesday. We had Infotech up slightly. There's some news about BlackBerry in the pre-market this morning that could help the Infotech sector on Thursday. Industrials were up. They're back on a buy signal. We had metals and mining up. They're back on a buy signal. We had materials continue to move higher. Pullback in telecom stocks yesterday back into the channel. And the venture exchange is back on a buy signal as of Wednesday's close. Looking at commodity prices, no change for copper. Looking at gold, gold was down slightly yesterday. Silver was up slightly. We've got all the energies still on sell signals here, so no change for Brent crude. For West Texas crude, had an inside day on Wednesday. Fairly quiet day for gasoline as well, for heating oil. And natural gas had an inside day on Wednesday. Close above $3.12 would give us a new buy signal. We generated a sell signal yesterday. That got us out of our bullish ETF, but did not get us into our bearish ETF. Let's finish off this morning's presentation with a quick look at a couple of 60-minute charts for the TSX. Still projecting higher prices here. New early warning signal there, so we'll have to see if we can play through that on Thursday. There's the previous resistance. We've got a nice band in there from back at the December highs, just at the Christmas rally there, and then it all faded away. So we're now starting to trade above the hourly flypaper channel, which of course is bullish. Next target to the upside is 14,687, then 14,843 and change. And then, of course, if we can take that out, we're working our way all the way back up to 15,000. On the downside on Thursday, an hourly close below 14,441 would give us a new intraday sell signal on Thursday. Okay, folks, that is all for Thursday morning. Dow futures currently up about 80 points, looking for continued volatility in the pre-market this morning. Have a great day, and we'll talk to you again soon.